subscribe to our YouTube channel so I can try to do things with my hands more. I don't know. Anyways, we got some bars over here that are new, and we want to show you why they're on this bike, why they exist, and why you need them. So we have the maker, the creator, Satya Kraus here. He came down just to go over these bars and show us how to set them up, why we need them.
So these are the ERG bars, and the name comes from ergonomics. We talk a lot about ergonomics, right? Rider position, rider setup, and we want you to be comfortable on the bike, but we're not talking about couch comfort, right? We're not talking about in your lazy boy, sitting back, and in a position that's not aggressive. So we want you to be comfortable so that you can control the bike. Let's look at the bars a little bit. These bars are adjustable. So this area right here, this area tilts like this. You can move them in and out, and the whole idea is to get your elbows and your wrists in the right position. What we talk about when we come from dirt riding or aggressive riding, we want to put our elbows up. Your elbows, when you get your elbows up, you can move your body around a lot more. You can get your lower body moving on the bike. And so elbows up helps a lot, and these bars, you can do that. You can spin them out of a little bit and get your elbows right in the right position. Wrists too. If your hands are falling asleep, check your wrist position. Your hands are gonna fall asleep if your wrists are in the wrong position. And so elbow and wrist stuff, it makes a huge difference. We've got a little bit of pullback we can do in these bars, right? And this, we can also adjust the bars in the risers and pull them towards you. So if you're a little bit smaller guy or shorter arms, you know, you can pull the bars back towards you and then get your wrist stable. You have a little bit of height adjustment in this thing too. We say there's about 3/4 of an inch of height adjustment. We don't want to go too far on these, but you can bring them up a little bit too. These ones have about 4.5 inches of rise, and you take the rise from the center of the bar here where they mount in the riser to your hand position. That's about 4.5 inches. The reason we like that on these bikes especially is that if you do have a screen or gauges, it's a lot easier to see that screen and gauges. And if you're running these type of risers, these moto risers, we have more view of the screen. So whereas like a bike like this, this is a 2.5 inch rise bar. This is a fly moto bar. And you see how the risers are a lot higher. You're not gonna see the screen as easy on these. And this one, this is a what size riser we got on that thing?
10.
That's a 10-inch riser, 10-inch kickback riser, and we've got a T-Rex pullback plate. And the T-Rex pullback plate on this bike allows us to be able to run risers. So this is a batwing fairing. With a batwing fairing, we run the T-Rex pullback plate, and then we can run either a straight riser or a kickback riser.
Now on these guys, that bike compared to this bike, on these bar setups, if we look, the handlebars are pretty much similar for height on both bikes. This one, the riser is lower, so if I'm using this bike, I have nothing impeding my hand movement to my radio, my navigation, whatever I want to do here. It's a little easier. The setup on Mike's bike, you can see the radio because the bars have the kickback and you can have a clear thing, but you are reaching over it a little more. So something to keep in mind when you pick it up, if you're not hitting it a lot and you're real comfortable with maneuvering and going through your controls from your handlebars on your radio, more of that setup. If you're more comfortable hitting it and you want a little bit more visibility, this is gonna be a better setup for you. This one has adjustability, so like you talked about earlier, your hands are going numb, you loosen a couple bolts, you position it, you torque them back down, you have a new feel. If we go with the setup to the left here, the fly moto bars, you can just rotate them back or forward and that's it. You have no swing in and out for your hands. They're both great, great setups. They both feel really, really good. More adjustability, easier to function the radio with your hands compared to that setup. We do sell more of this setup so far, but since this is newer to the market, I think guys are just catching on. And it's one of the reasons we want to do a video, because we get a bunch of phone calls about these bars, and we've had customers buy both, and we've had good feedback on both.
I'm riding these ERG bars on my Street Glide, and I love them. And what I'll do is, if I'm going on a long ride, I'll loosen them up and I'll adjust it a little bit, right? If I know I'm gonna be out ripping the canyons or something like that, I'll put them in a more straight, aggressive position. If I'm gonna be longer on the road or something, I can tune them in and get my elbows down a little bit more and get a little more comfort for the long haul. So that's why I really like the ERG bars. The fly bars, a little bit more aggressive. If you're really like, look, I'm a short distance rider, I'm really out there hitting canyons pretty much all the time, you know, the fly bars are a good place. If you're doing wheelies and stuff like that, we kind of stick with the fly bars. You get a little more strength in the fly bars than the ERGs, just because of the adjustability.
And then with this guy too, that we've talked about a couple times, if you get the wrong rise from the get-go, we can swap out the bottom part and they are sold in 2-inch increments.
On the risers, we're doing a 6-inch.
We have a 6-inch riser to an 8, to a 10, to a 12?
Yep.
Okay, so you have that set up. So if you wanna swap out your risers here, this part from the bottom, we have a 6 from the smallest all the way to a 12 in 2-inch increments. So you have a 6, an 8, a 10, and a 12 to pair with each one of these styles. So what we've realized is a 12-inch overall with bar and riser, you can still use your factory cables right from Harley. You do have to get the wire extensions for your electronics, but they use the factory cables. If we go beyond the 12-inch setup on them, that is when we are going to aftermarket cables. Clutch line, brake lines.
I'd love to chat about height a little bit. We get a lot of questions about height, right? We get a lot of guys going, look, I'm this tall, I'm 6'3", whatever it is, what height should I go with, right? And a lot of it is preference. A lot of it is like what feels good to me, right? But when we talk about performance, we want to also include what that height's going to do to the bike. A higher bar is going to make that bike feel heavier. Anytime you bring your bars up, the bike's going to feel heavier, especially at slow speeds. So you want to think about that, right? You want to get your, you know, there's kind of a look thing going on, right? But when you bring your hands down a little bit, you actually can control the bike a little bit more. So usually we tell people, if you think you want a 14, let's look at a 12, right? Let's look at a 12, 12 and a half. Let's go in that range and see what you think about that. So it does give the opportunity to kind of get into a bar and then adjust it as, you know, as you like down the road if you need to.
And, you know, I run the 10-inch pullbacks with the fly bar on my bike, and it feels really good. It's the same setup that's on this guy. Your hands aren't over your shoulders or a couple inches under your shoulders. Mike's about, what, 5'10"? 5'9". And look, he's not a real tall guy or anything and still has it. So if you're 6 foot, it's a 12-inch bar, but with the pullback, it puts you in a really good spot. I travel with those bars. And when I go on long rides, like if we're going around the Great Lakes or something, I'm on the bike for 4 days, I don't have a problem. I'm 5'11", and they're perfect. Exactly. Look at this. I can see my radio. I can touch it. I'm missing the bottom part, but nothing major. If I'm using music, looking at music, trying to figure out what track, radio station, I'm following directions from my nav, I'm good to go with this bar setup. The other bar setup, not as easy. This bar setup, if you want a more aggressive bar, you want that performance bagger feel, you need to use your radio on a Batwing bike, this is your setup. Very nice and adjustable. Highly recommended.
The other thing that we got with this setup, which we didn't talk about the risers much, but these risers, a real difference in these risers is that these risers are solid mounted to the triple tree. And our bushings, our rubber bushings are up in here in these risers instead of down here. So when you push on these things, they don't push as much. They feel solid, feel like a solid mount setup, but you still have the vibration damping. These bars are also all aluminum. This bottom piece is aluminum, this is aluminum, and your bar ends are aluminum. And so the aluminum works differently with the vibration than with a steel bar would. There's also a lightness to it. And when you have a really light bar, your bars don't have a tendency to throw the handling off the bike. They don't flop as much.
Mounting down here, a typical bar, if you're not solid mounted at the bottom and you have your bushing down here, a bar like this, you have 12 inches of leverage. and we've gone over this in some of other videos we post, 12 inches. This is a 4-inch bar, you know, pretty much set up here with the bushing right here. So you're talking about 4.5 inches of leverage on the bushing as opposed to 12. The positive feel you have to the rear end once you have these is next to none on a Harley.
Yeah.
Boom.
Yeah. I like it. Looks
good. That's it, boys and girls. Go fast. Turn fast. Stop fast. Bigger, faster, stronger.